Yeah, Anand, good evening, doctor. Yeah, Anand, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
I'm Dr. Vijender speaking from your PD, Anand. How are you?
I'm fine, sir.
Okay, Anand, you know, are you ready for the mock interview?
Yes, sir.
Are you using earplug?
Pardon, sir?
Are you using earplug for discussion?
Yes, sir.
Then I have some three more mentors with me from electrical background. And okay, Anand, I believe we will go for the mock interview with you in direction of PSU, right?
Yes, sir.
So, Anand, my first question to you is about your introduction only. आप अपनी ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन हम लोगों को दें. कैन यू प्लीज इंट्रोड्यूस योरसेल्फ?
यस सर, आई एम आनंद केपी एंड माय नेटिव प्लेस इज कन्नूर डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ केरला. आई कंप्लीटेड माय बीटेक इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम एनआईटी कैलिकट. माय मेजर प्रोजेक्ट टॉपिक इज फोटोवोल्टाइक इन्वर्टर एंड आई हैव डन माय ट्रेनिंग एट ट्रांसफॉर्मर्स एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल्स केरला लिमिटेड एंड माय I spend my leisure time playing badminton and table tennis and watching movies. That's it, sir.
Okay, when did you graduate, Vimal? When did you graduate?
Yes, sir. I graduated in 2018, sir.
2018 mein you graduated, huh?
Yes, sir.
And can you tell me about your GATE score?
Sir, my GATE score is 834 and I attended in 2019, sir.
Okay, so why you want to join this PSU, Anand?
Sir, in the private companies, they are always running behind profits and all those things. And I think that PSUs are more aligned towards nation building and they think about nation rather than profits, sir.
Okay, so because PSUs are into nation building, so you want to join PSUs, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so Anand, can you tell me something about your hobbies?
Sir, I play badminton and table tennis, sir, and I also watch Hindi movies, sir.
Hindi movies?
Yeah, Hindi movies.
Are you comfortable in Hindi speaking and understanding?
I can understand Hindi, sir. I am not that comfortable in speaking Hindi. That is a bit difficult.
Okay, but you like Hindi movies, huh?
Yes, sir.
Any recent Hindi movie you have seen?
Recent, actually I used to watch not exactly Hindi, but Hindi dubbed movies, sir, in YouTube.
Okay, that means the movie, Bollywood movie in your language, some other language.
Yeah, some other language which is in dubbed into Hindi, sir. Right.
So it's a Malayali or something like that you listen?
No, I watch Malayalam and also Telugu movies also, sir.
As a Telugu also you understand, huh?
No, I can't understand Telugu, but which are dubbed into Hindi. They will be dubbed into Hindi and I can hear it in Hindi.
Okay, good. Okay, I have a question to ask you. Nowadays, this privatization or this disinvestment of PSUs is being talked about.
Yes, sir.
Do you think that is a right decision?
Sir, in some way it should be done, sir. Some way it should not be done. Because if you see in the oil companies, like there are three to four oil companies which are working in the same field. And if these companies are, some of them are disinvested and merged into only one PSU, then it will be useful such a way that there won't be competition between the PSUs.
Okay.
In that way, if we see it is good, sir. And also if the company like BSNL, which is the only government player in that field, if we are disinvesting that, then it will be a big issue. So those kind of PSUs should not be disinvested, sir.
Okay, so profit making should not be disinvested, and loss making should be disinvested. That is what you are saying.
No, sir. Like it depends on the number of players, sir. In case of telecommunication, only BSNL is there, sir. So it should not be disinvested. It should be maintained as a government only. But in case of oil companies, there are three to four oil companies, and if they are merging all of them into one, then I am okay with it.
Okay.
There should not be competition among the government companies, sir.
But is it okay for you to think of PSU at the time when disinvestment is being talked about and privatization we are thinking of?
Yes, sir. Okay.
So you still want to join, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What are your favorite subjects, Anand?
My favorite subjects are control system, electrical machines and electrical circuits, sir.
Okay, so Dushyant sir, can we go with the control system then?
Yes, sir.
Followed by Vimal sir and ma'am. Okay. So you can go ahead.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Okay. Control system is a dynamic system or a static system?
Pardon, sir?
Hello? Control system is a dynamic system or a static system?
Control system, dynamic system, sir.
Dynamic why?
Like it is having memory also, sir. Dynamic system is it is having memory, sir. So it depends on the past input.
Where we use memory in control system?
I don't know, sir. I'm not getting it, sir.
Okay. Then explain stability.
Stability of a system is like if the impulse response of a system is absolutely integrable, then that system is stable, sir. And if you are giving a bounded input to the system, then if it gives a bounded output, then you can call it a BIBO stable system, sir.
Can you explain what is BIBO stability and asymptotic stability?
When we are giving a bounded input to the system and if we are getting a bounded output, then we can call it a BIBO stable system, sir.
Okay.
And if the asymptotic means if the if the absolute integral of impulse response is giving a finite value, then we can call it as asymptotic
stability. No, it is also called as BIBO stability. It is not asymptotic stability. Okay. What is sensitivity?
What, sir?
Sensitivity of a control system.
Sensitivity is the ratio of percentage change in something with respect to the percentage change in the other.
For a good control system, the sensitivity is high or low?
It should be low, sir.
Why?
Because it should not be more sensitive. Even though the output, the input is it should be depends on which sensitivity. It should be more sensitive to the changes in the input rather than the system, sir. System.
Okay. You can say that. What is controllability and observability?
Controllability, I exactly don't know, sir. Controllability, I don't know that, sir.
Okay, how you can find the stability of the system using root locus?
Root locus system.
Yeah.
Sir, if the root locus plot is not crossing the geomag axis, then we can say that the system is always stable.
Okay. The plot of what is the plot of root locus?
It is the path whenever the gain is changed. It is the path traveled by the poles of the open loop transfer function.
Open loop transfer function. Then how we can say that it is a stable system when we our closed loop system is a stable system when you go to the right side.
Closed loop transfer function pole, sir. It's a path pole of the closed loop transfer function pole.
Okay. Can you explain what is gain margin and what is phase margin?
Gain margin is the inverse of the gain of the open loop, the loop transfer function, sir, at the phase crossover frequency.
Okay, what is phase crossover frequency?
The phase crossover frequency is the frequency at which the phase of the system becomes 180 degrees.
Okay. Can you explain how we can find stability using polar plot?
Polar plot, if the polar plot encloses, if the -1, 0 point is enclosed by the power cord, then the system is not stable, sir. If it is not enclosed, then the system is stable.
Okay, can we find gain margin and phase margin from polar plots?
Yes, sir, we can find.
How?
The gain margin can be found out by the point of, we can find the point of intersection of the polar plot with the negative real axis. And if we take the inverse of that magnitude, then we will get the gain margin.
Okay, okay. Sir, please continue.
Okay, sir.
Hello?
Phase margin can be found out by the point of intersection of the polar plot
I know
you. Unit.
Okay. Hello? Hi, sir. Please continue.
Hi.
Bimal, sir?
Yes, sir. Bimal here, and I want to ask question in electrical something. Electrical magnetic machine. Okay?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
So, can you please define the efficiency of a three-phase induction motor? Why it is less than of a three-phase transformer?
Pardon, sir? Three-phase?
Three-phase induction motor efficiency is less than three-phase transformer. Why?
Sir, in the case of three-phase induction motor, there is air gap coming in between the stator and the rotor, sir. So the power transfer capability is less in if you consider the three-phase induction motor. But in case of the transformer, there is like the power, the core is completely like the core is entirely the closed circuit is through the magnetic circuit. So the power transfer capability is more in transformer than in induction machine.
Okay. Could you please tell me why series field winding has low resistance than that of the field winding resistance, shunt field winding resistance?
Three-phase winding resistance is having?
No. I am asking why the series field winding having the low resistance in comparison to shunt field winding resistance in motor?
I don't know, sir. I'm not getting it.
No idea?
Not that.
So then tell me what are the conditions to be satisfied when we jointly operate the two generators in parallel operation?
Two generators, the first the frequency should be same, sir.
Okay.
The voltage rating should be same and the phase sequence also should be same, sir.
Okay. And then our next question, mine. What is the reactance voltage? What is the reactance voltage?
Reactance voltage?
Yeah.
I don't remember.
Okay, no problem. Then tell me what is the principle on which electric motor works?
Sir, electric motor works on the principle of Lorentz force equation, sir. Whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it will experience a force.
Yeah.
That is the principle behind the electric motor, sir.
Okay. Then which law is satisfied? Stephen's law of left hand or right hand? Fleming's law of left hand or right hand?
Electric motor, na, sir?
Yeah.
It follows left hand rule.
Okay. And in generator?
Right hand rule, sir.
Can you please elaborate the right hand rule of?
Right hand rule, explain.
Yeah.
Sir, in the Fleming's right hand rule, the thumb represents the move motion.
What?
The thumb represents the motion, sir. Motion of the conductor.
Yeah.
And the point finger represents the magnetic field. And the middle finger represents the EMF direction in which the current EMF is induced.
Okay. EMF having direction or current having direction?
Current direction.
Okay. Then could you please tell me how we can control the speed of the DC motor? What are the methods to be adopted when we control the speed of the DC motor?
Sir, in DC shunt motor, we can use armature resistance control method. So control one method is armature control method, and another method is field flux control method.
Okay, can you please elaborate?
In armature resistance control method, we will be putting in armature resistance and the speed. We can reduce the speed of the motor, and that is more applicable to constant loads. In field flux control method, we can control the speed of the motor above the rated speed, and that is more suitable for constant power load.
Okay. When we start the DC motor, why is the starting current so high? How we can reduce?
So when the DC motor is started, the speed of the motor is zero. So the back EMF induced will be zero. So the ratio of VT by RI will be very high. So a large current will be drawn. So to reduce the current, we are putting starter.
Okay. When we control the speed of the induction motor, what are the methods to be adopted?
So to control the speed of the induction motor, pole changing methods armature resistance control method or constant V by F control method.
Okay. How we can reduce the AD current losses?
Pardon, sir?
AD current losses in the transformers.
AD current losses, we can reduce the AD current losses by laminating the core.
And what are the losses occurred in the transformer?
As are the losses that are the iron losses and the copper losses, sir. In iron
when
losses,
they are occurred? When the one the what are the phenomena when they occurred?
Iron losses are because of the copper losses are because of the current flow.
No, I'm asking both iron loss and copper loss. You haven't answered iron losses.
Which one is? I didn't get the question, sir.
Both. Have you told me two types of losses, iron loss and copper loss? Then elaborate both. Sir. What is the phenomena? What is the occurrence? How we can detect these losses?
Okay, sir. Using the no load test, short circuit test.
In which mode?
Open circuit.
When we did open circuit and we did short circuit, in which type of load?
I don't know, sir.
Okay. No problem. Have you studied winding?
No, sir. I don't have much idea about the winding, sir. Okay. I know only lap winding and wave winding, not more than that.
Then what is the value of A in lap and wave?
A is parallel path, right, sir?
Yeah.
Lap winding, then parallel path will be equal to number of poles, sir.
Okay. Can you please define what is the back EMF and what is the significance of back EMF?
Back EMF is it is the opposition offered to the because of back EMF only we are able to convert the power from mechanical energy to electric energy.
No, what is the significance? I am asking what is the significance in DC motors of back EMF? So what is the formula? What is the formula of finding out back EMF in DC shunt motor? Or general formula, you can explain general formula.
VT minus IA into resistance, sir.
And the general formula?
EB equal to K into phi into omega.
What is the value of K?
K is ZP by 2P, ZP by 2 pi A.
What is?
Z into P by 2 pi A is the value of K.
Okay. Can you please elaborate the terms used in this formula?
Z is the number of conductors, P is the number of poles, A is the number of parallel paths.
Okay. Then please tell me what is the ratings of the power transformer? How we can calculate or how we can define this much of amount should be in power transformer?
rating of power transformer.
Yeah.
KVA, sorry, like KVA will KVA or MVA?
KVA stands for
the kilovolt amp.
Okay, and KBAR?
Sir, pardon sir?
KBAR.
KBAR stands for kilovolt and the reactive.
Okay. Reactive. Can you please elaborate reactive power, apparent power and active power?
Reactive power, apparent power is equal to the...
I am asking definition. I am not asking formula. I am asking definition. Okay, sir.
Real power is the power that we are consuming, sir, that we can actually consume. And the reactive power is the power which is transferred between the source and load so that this cancel.
And what is the relation of in among these three?
Reactive power square plus real power square is equal to the apparent power square.
Okay, thank you. Over to you, sir. Vision, sir. Over
yeah, ma'am, you have already asked.
Okay, sir. Yes.
Hello.
You have asked.
Hello.
Yeah, Roshan, you have done?
No, sir.
Yes, sir. I am done. I hand over to you.
Okay. Roshan, you can go ahead.
Okay. So, hello, Anand.
Hello.
How are you, Anand?
Fine, madam.
Okay. You are in Kerala now?
Pardon, madam.
You are in Kerala now, no?
Yes, madam. I am in Kerala now.
Okay. So, tell me from where you have done your training?
Training? I have done my training from Transformers Electrical Kerala Limited, madam.
Transformers. Okay. Tell me the type of testing done in Transformers.
Testing. So, madam, the tests done are short circuit test and open circuit test, madam. These were the tests.
Okay. One open circuit test and?
Short circuit test.
Okay. Tell me something about that.
Open circuit test, we are doing it to find out the no load losses of the transformer. And short circuit test, we are doing it to find the full load losses or proper losses of the transformer.
Okay. Tell me some more difference between open circuit and short circuit test.
In open circuit test, the voltage we are keeping at the rated value. And secondary will be keeping it as open circuited, and we will be doing open circuit test mostly in the low voltage winding, and we will be doing the short circuit test in the high voltage winding, and also we will be keeping the secondary closed in case of short circuit test.
Okay. So you said open circuit test is done on a low voltage side and short circuit test is done on the high voltage side, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So why we do so?
Because in open circuit test, if we are doing it on low voltage side, the current means the voltage we have to keep will be less. It means the rated voltage we have to keep will be less, and also the current will be more, so that under the non-load condition the current will be very less. But if you are doing it on low voltage side, the current will be a bit more than compared to the high voltage side. So we can take the measurement easily. And if in case of short circuit test, if you are doing the test on high voltage side, the current will be the rated current which you have to keep will be less. So the rating of the measurement equipment used will be less.
Okay. So you have seen the construction of transformer. How we construct the transformer? In training center.
Pardon, madam?
Have you seen how we construct the transformer in training center?
No, madam. No, madam.
So, can you tell me which winding is placed near to the insulator or core? Which winding is placed near to the core?
Low voltage winding will be kept near to the core and high voltage winding will be kept outside.
Why is it so?
Because of the requirement of insulation will be less for a low voltage winding than the high voltage winding. So that the windings will be coming more closer to the core, and because of that the leakage flux will be less. So because of that they are using low voltage.
Good. So tell me, what is active device and what is passive device?
Active devices are devices whose VI characteristics, like will be either in like its VI characteristics will be passing through the third quadrant, fourth quadrant, or the second quadrant, in which, like, that means it can supply power, madam. And okay, its passive devices are which are like whose VI characteristics will be in the second quadrant or the fourth quadrant, and they cannot give power, they will be accepting the power.
So you are telling that active transmitter or active device are one which can give power, right?
Yes, madam.
Okay. So transformer is active or passive?
Actually, transformer is generally, if you are talking, it is a passive device, but when it is bias powered by the base emitter junction, power bias and alter emitter junction is reverse bias, which will be under
active. See, I am talking about transformer. Transformer is
transformer is a passive device.
Why? It is also transforming the power, no? Why is it passive?
But it cannot generate on its own, madam. It requires a source to power it. Separate source to power it.
So tell me the application of DC shunt motor and DC series motor.
DC shunt motor is used for constant speed characteristics required, madam.
Okay, because so what are the application? Where we require constant speed?
I don't remember, madam.
Okay, exactly. Tell me about DC series motor.
In DC series motor, we are using it for high starting torque is required, madam.
So, high starting torque is required.
I don't remember.
Can you please tell me the working of ceiling fan working?
Working of?
Ceiling fan.
Fan. Okay. Yes. Madam, fan we are using capacitor start and run induction motor, single phase induction motor, madam.
Right. Okay. So tell me the principle.
Principle in this one, in single phase induction motor, the starting torque will be normally, it will be zero. So in order to provide the starting torque, we are using a capacitor in parallel, in series with the auxiliary winding.
So why is starting torque is zero in single phase induction motor?
Because the the double field rotating theory is both like the forward torque and the backward torque offward will be same, so it will be zero in case of
single phase. Okay, fine. So which capacitor we use generally? Which type of capacitor? There are several type of capacitors, right? So which capacitor we use?
Electrolytic capacitors.
Right. Electrolytic capacitors we use generally, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Do you hear about universal motor?
Universal motor. Yes, madam.
Don't tell me. Just tell me why it is called universal.
Because it can be used both as a series motor and shunt motor.
Is it so? How is so?
I heard it, I'm not sure.
Series or AC or DC? I mean, both for both polarity.
AC and DC. AC and DC.
AC or DC are for both polarity of current.
Yes. Yes.
So, universal motor is basically series motor, okay?
Okay.
So, tell me, if we done a hole in the transformer core, okay, what will happen?
If we
put hole in transformer core, what will happen?
If we put hole, actually the I don't know, madam. Exactly, I don't know.
Leave it. So, tell me what type of supply system we use in Indian Railway for traction, or this motor?
Railway.
Yes, Indian Railway for traction.
Usually we use, I think it, we will use induction motor, madam.
Induction motor. And earlier?
Earlier we were using DC shunt motor, madam.
DC shunt. Are you sure DC shunt?
DC shunt, yes, I think so. DC shunt only, madam.
Okay. I think now we can give him feedback, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay.
So, Anand, as you asked about application, okay.
Yes,
so,
okay,
you know the graph and you know what is the property of the promoter, but you don't know exactly the application, right?
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes, madam.
So, prepare the all application. Okay. Prepare the application, two or three application of all motors. Okay.
Okay, madam. Okay.
Then you answered good for the about ceiling fan. So you use single cell induction motor, and if it is asked about the working, then please explain the working of single cell induction motor. And you are right, okay. We use electrolytic capacitor. Okay.
Okay.
And if we put a hole in transformer, so basically what happens, reluctance will increase. Now. Okay. Because the air reluctance will increase. So I read that topic also. And one thing you said, for Indian Railway, you use DC fan, earlier we used to use DC series motor, not DC fan motor.
Okay,
we require high starting torque, no? So we have to use DC series motor because of the high torque, okay? Other things are good. Okay, best of luck.
Okay, Vimal sir, I think you can give your feedback now.
Okay.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Yeah, Vimal sir, you can give feedback to Anand.
Okay. Anand, you are lagging somewhere because you studied hard, but you have not. You just prepared for getting his course. I think you put all your hard work in numericals. I think I am right or not?
Sir. Yes, sir.
So.
Yes, sir.
So take some notes from the seniors and whatever you have done, coaching or self-study, and go through the thoroughly from your notebooks, and your knowledge will be enhanced. Okay? You are strong. I think you are very much strong in numerical solving, right? Am I right or not?
Yes, sir.
So prepare for theoretical knowledge also, and you will surely, I hope you will get whatever you want in your life. Okay, Dushan sir,
your feedback.
Firstly, we start with the control system is a dynamic system or static system. All control systems are in dynamic system because of transient part of its response. If we apply an input, it directly not give an exact output. There will be some transient part in it. Okay, that's why every control system is dynamic control system, and we are going through the controllability and observability. You don't know about this, what is controllability, and there are two type of controllability, state controllability and output controllability. You can go to a book, this name as Norman Nice karke book aati hai.
Okay.
Study this book, you can get benefit from this.
Okay, sir, let me say one thing. Hello, Anand. Can you hear me?
Yes, madam.
Transformer is active or passive. So, transformer is passive because it can't amplify the power, no? Because in transformer, input power is equal to output power, right?
Yes.
Okay, so it can't amplify power, that's why it is passive device, okay?
And it's a Bimal here, and I want to say something. I have asked you one question, why series winding having low resistance and shunt winding having high resistance. You can't give that answer. So for when we put low resistance in series, then current will pass higher. And okay. That's why. And you know when the diameter R equals to rho L open here. That you know the formula.
Yes.
Okay. So. The diameter will be what, more or less?
In series winding, it will be less. Parallel.
No.
Series winding, it will be more.
There is no relation of series or parallel in the diameter case.
Okay.
So Anand, I think you had many questions from different mentors. So we will be sending this audio clip to you. Aap sare questions ko, you just go through all the questions and prepare the answers also. Our mentors have given you answers also and suggested you how to prepare also. as far as the PSU is concerned, Anand, so PSU mein HR part will also be there. Why you want to join PSUs related to your hobbies, related to your strong weak points? So that every HR part will also be there, your introduction and all.
Okay.
So anyhow, this was a little stress towards the technical. HR part I will again discuss with you in the next mock when we have. So whenever you get call from some PSUs, which you will surely get, so whenever you get call, you please intimate Nikita ma'am and then we can go for next mock also. Fine, Anand?
Okay. Okay.
Okay, chalo, thank you, Anand. Thanks a lot to all the mentors.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.